What's up, my people? My name is Willie the Tech Guy. And this week we just saw the debut, the launch of the Oppo Reno 5. I loved what they did in that launch. They launched two phones. That's the Oppo Reno 5 and the Oppo Reno 5F. These are two amazing devices. And as I sat down during that launch, because I got to tune in live, as I was just watching that launch, I remember asking myself, is it worth it? Is it worth the upgrade to move from a Reno 4 to a Reno 5? You know, is it worth the upgrade? Because now, you see, normally most phone companies take about a year to bring out their next phone in their line, you know, so that they can go through all the tech that has come out, pick what suits them, and just put them, you know, in their next phone. But Oppo began a new trend where they took 6 months, and you know, every phone has been coming in the Reno series has been coming up about after like 6 months. So is it worth, you know, is 6 months enough to have updates in technology? And the question is actually astoundingly yes, because technology is not static. Technology is always evolving. So we're always getting to see something new every single day churning out in terms of technology. And I like the fact that now this guy's over at Oppo sat down and said, you know, instead of us waiting for a long period of time before we can release the next phone in the line, let's just take 6 months, give them a new refresh, give them a new phone, so that these guys also have a lot of choice at their hands and they can get to enjoy, you know, the best phone in the new line. Now, we have a new contender at the 40,000 bracket, but this new contender is a worthy contender. This is the Reno 5. I'm happy that I got a chance to get the Reno 5 myself. And as I look at these phones, I just pick them up from the table. The first thing that I see is, you know, that camera module update. The Reno 4 had an amazing design. You know, and I love a couple of elements about this. I love the cameras. I love the fact that it was a very lightweight. I love all the new things it came with, like smart spying prevention, you know, all those air gestures. It was really a good phone. And you see, sometimes if you have something good, you don't need to change it up. You just need to tweak it and make it better. And that's what they did with the Oppo Reno 5. So you have a bigger camera module that speaks, that just stuns you. You know, if you hold this phone up to your ear and you're making a call, now, you know, it gives you that, you know, it pops out. Unlike the Reno 4, which had a smaller camera bump, this one has a bigger one and bigger camera modules. And not only are these bigger camera modules, but we're talking about updated cameras. The Oppo Reno 4 came with a 48 megapixel main camera, but the Oppo Reno 5 comes in at a whooping 64 megapixel camera. Now, what does this mean? It means as you have better resolution photos, better low light photography, because you know all those pixels coming together to give you a better shot. And it is clearly evident out from the pictures that I just took a few minutes ago from this, just as I was testing out the cameras, it has better, you can ideally tell from this that it has better resolution, better sharpness because of that updated sensor. Not only do the back cameras get an update in design, but also the front cameras. Now, the Oppo Reno 4 had a dual punch out with a 32 megapixel selfie shooter, but the Oppo Reno 5 comes with an updated 44 megapixel selfie camera. So you're talking about bigger resolution for even your selfie shots and better pictures even in low light performance. And you know me, bigger sometimes is actually better. Not only do you get, you know, that real estate in terms of about the selfie camera, but also getting a slightly better display. The Oppo Reno 4 came with an OLED display that was 6.4 inches, but the Reno 5 comes with a Super AMOLED display that goes all the way to 6.43. So that 0.03 inch in terms of display size might be inconceivable to the eye, but it's actually better because you're getting a bigger or a larger screen to body ratio with the Oppo Reno 5. So you're getting a better display with this. And not only Are you getting a better display in terms of screen to body ratio and AMOLED? You're also getting 90 hertz of smooth scrolling refresh rate. The Oppo Reno 4 has 60 hertz. The Oppo Reno 5 has 90 hertz. Your eyes will get used to the better scrolling animations, you know, the better moving in between apps. You know, you're enjoying your Instagram, you're enjoying your YouTube, you're enjoying your gaming. You get to enjoy that better resolution and better frame rates with the Oppo Reno 5. So updated camera modules, an updated display, and not only that, to power it up, you also have an updated battery. This comes with a 4,015 milliampere battery, but this one gives you a 4,310 milliampere battery. That extra milliamperes is sure definitely gonna give you updated battery life. So that's longer battery life and better, you know, just all the way better. And not only that, the Oppo Reno 4 came with a 30 watt VOOC charger. The Oppo Reno 5 comes in with a 50 watt super VOOC charger. This is able to juice up your phone in minutes. The time to take the Reno 4, it takes the Reno 5 even much more. Less time to get juiced up from 0 to 100 so that you can enjoy your gaming, you can enjoy your content consumption. Can you imagine all this in a period of about 6 months? These are some of the good updates that you have with the Oppo Reno. Now, these are not just all of them. There are many things that are embedded in the UI. Now, this came with ColorOS 7.2 based on Android 10. The Oppo Reno 5 out the box comes with ColorOS 11.1 based on Android 11. So you're getting all those updated tweaks in Android 11 that makes your experience of using this phone way much more better. We're talking about better customization, better customizing your home screen, your apps, how you like them to look. You have more options with the Oppo Reno 5 because of ColorOS 11.1. And only that gives you better features, you know, like silhouette videography and some of these things that we're going to talk about in the actual review. There are things with the Reno 5 that you can do that the Reno 4 could not do. And these are some of the things, and if you ask me, some of the things that I would consider when upgrading from a previous phone. So the question we are trying to answer, is it worth it? Tell us in the comment section whether you think it is worth it before I tell you, because I totally think that better cameras, better battery, better display, all these are in the ingredients that are chosen to make the perfect upgrade in a phone. So for me, it is worth the upgrade. Remember, follow us on Tech and Africa, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Let's continue the conversations. Let's talk about the Reno 5. I know we are in the pre-order period, and I tell you the truth, it's a very good opportunity for you to grab yourself one because of some of the things that they have in their pre-order bundle. But the Oppo Reno 5 has me drooling, especially this fantastic silver that is so fantastic. See you in the next video. Peace out.